Assessing and Controlling Risk, a Guide for Business. Video 3, Implement Controls. The controls you set up to prevent your business activity from posing a risk to human health and the environment is a key priority. Let's discuss the third of these steps, how to implement controls.
The most effective control is to eliminate the hazard and any associated risks. The second most effective control is to substitute the source of the hazard with something safer, or to reduce the risk of the hazard with engineering controls. Secondary containment, such as bunding, can be used in conjunction with automated shutoff systems, meaning there is no need for a person to be present operating the equipment to shut it down. Administrative controls are the least effective type of controls, as they rely on people doing the right thing and taking care at all times, introducing the risk of human error.
An example of a preventative control is the safe storage of potentially hazardous liquids. The respective mitigating control is a spill kit that can be quickly deployed in the event of a spill. Another preventative control is designating a wash area where the ground is impervious and sloped towards a drain, which leads to a storage tank. This prevents the wastewater from being washed down into the stormwater system. All identified hazards and their associated risks can be recorded in a register. This enables key personnel to understand the business's risk profile, record existing controls for hazards and risks, and address risk as part of decision-making processes. It is also helpful in identifying when new controls may be introduced to further address any residual risk.
Regular reviews can help maintain your business's focus on hazard controls, as well as supporting continuous improvement.